Hello my dear students and welcome back to Balaji online classes. I'm Rabia Khatun and today I'll be teaching you English grammar of class 7th. We'll be studying chapter number 28 of your book and the name of the chapter is Polar Bears. This is also a comprehension from your book and there is a passage given about polar bears and you have to answer the following questions that are given. So let's study. Polar bears are the largest land carnivores in the world. You all know what are carnivores? That eat meat or flesh of other animals. So these polar bears are the largest carnivores in the world. They roam the thick Arctic sea ice around the North Pole and the shores of Canada, Russia, Alaska, Greenland and Norway near the Arctic Ocean. So basically they live on the North Pole. They live on the poles where there is extremely cold weather. They roam near the shores of Arctic Ocean. Okay. Their bodies are naturally capable of surviving the harsh cold of the north. So they live in extremely cold weather, and their body is made in such a way that they are able to survive the harsh cold conditions of the North Pole. They have a thick white coat of fur which grows all over their body, even at the bottom of their paws. So I guess you must have, if you have not seen in real, then you must have seen in pictures that polar bears have a covering of fur along their whole body, even on their paws. The white fur also provides them camouflage in their icy white environment. Beneath this white fur, they have black skin which absorbs heat from the sunlight. Since black color absorbs heat much and they have black skin, white fur ke niche unki black skin hoti hai, jo ki sunlight ko bahut acche se absorb kar leti hai. A layer of fat under their skin also helps to keep them warm. Then under the skin they have a layer of fat which also keeps them warm. They have broad feet and sharp claws to avoid slipping on ice and also for hunting prey. Polar bears are strong swimmers. So they have strong claws so that they cannot slip on the ice because they live in the icy area. They have to walk on ice. So they have strong claws so that they can fix their claws in the ice and then move. They do not slip. And they are very good swimmers. They hunt seals by traveling in the cold waters, by swimming or floating on ice sheets for long distances. So they swim in icy cold water and they hunt seals. They eat seals. Polar bears are intimidating creatures. Intimidating means overpowering creatures or scary creatures. And their body can grow up to 3 meters in length. They are so big that their body is around 3 meters in length and their weight is about 450 kilograms. They are powerful predators and have no enemies in nature. Human activities have largely been responsible for the loss of polar bears. Human activities, the activities which humans do, they are responsible for the extinct, for the polar bears that are being extinct. Polar bears are being considered as vulnerable creatures, vulnerable species. They have been hunted by humans for their fur and fat. Humans hunt them for their fur and fat, and that's why they are being banished from the environment. Most recently, climate change due to global warming has led to a loss of habitat for the polar bears. In 2008, they were declared a vulnerable species. So, most recently, the global warming, because of the global warming, the climatic conditions have changed, and there was a decline in the polar bears habitat, and they have been considered as the vulnerable species. It means that their population has been declining since these years, and as of 2015 their population was estimated between 22,000 to 30,000. Only all over the world their population is considered to be 22,000 to 30,000 only, since as estimated from 2015 se jo estimate kiya gaya usme sirf 22,000 se 30,000 tak hi polar bears reh gaye hain all over the world. So they are very less in number. They are a vulnerable species because their population is declining rapidly. So that was the passage. I hope you have understood whatever I have explained you. For the better understanding of this chapter, you can read it by your own. The notes of this chapter you will be getting on School Mitra app. You can download it from there and complete your work in your book and copy. Until my next video, bye bye and take care.